celebration of the 50th anniversary of the Apollo 13 mission. We have President and CEO here. Tell me about this suit, because I would love to get into this.
Thanks so much. This is actually Fred Hayes's pressurized suit. And so this suit would be worn underneath the suit that he would wear to walk on the moon. And so we're so fortunate here to have these unique artifacts that you can't see anyplace else. But this actually maintains the pressure on his body, because remember, the moon doesn't have an atmosphere. And so you have to create pressure to keep him well and healthy while he's walking on the surface of the moon. So all the Apollo moonwalkers wore these kind of pressurized suits underneath their clothing, underneath their spacesuits.
Nice. And we talked a little bit about when visitors come, they get to, I guess, choose a role here. And since I chose mission control, let's talk about the scrubber that helped save some lives in Apollo 13.
Absolutely. Everyone knows the story of Apollo 13, that the oxygen tank exploded. But what they then discovered was that from exhaling, the astronauts were building up carbon dioxide inside of the capsule, which could poison them. And so they had to figure out a way to scrub the air. And everyone knows that famous scene where the astronauts were, the flight controller said, this is all they have on board, we have to figure it out. So this is the scrubber box that flight controllers actually developed to scrub the air inside of the capsule. This is the real thing.
Nice. So since you reopened during this pandemic, you've also put in a lot of changes. We talked about, you know, people making sure that they have their time tickets before they get here, but you've also adjusted the very popular tram experience here.
Absolutely. So that was actually, honestly, one of the pain points. We'd have long lines of people waiting on trams, but now through our app, when you get here, you book your tram time with your whole party. And then you go enjoy Space Center Houston, you get a boarding pass, and you're paying 15 minutes before to go board the tram and go behind the scenes. So no longer have to wait in line.
All right, and I also want to mention you've got camps going on that people can sign up for. Those have started again.
Yes, we actually are doing clean room camps, and we're actually emulating NASA best practices. When you assemble satellites or other space hardware, prepare for a mission, disease control is really important. So we have clean room camps for ages 6 through high school, where all the participants actually don PPE, protective wear, and with face masks, and we go through all the safety protocols, and they're actually doing everything from rocketry to living in space to robotics, all in a clean room environment.
All right, in our last few seconds, let's head on over here. We're seeing those camps ongoing. And also, just before you come, definitely check out fox26houston.com. But they're encouraging you to bring water. And if you don't have a mask, they've got plenty of cool ones like the one I have bought. So you can check out our website for more info. Reporting live, Chelsea Edwards, Fox 26 News.